Hi, and welcome to another episode of Mr. Puzzle. And today it's time for episode number 2 of the Trick Lock mini-series. Last time we had a look at the 2015 Trick Lock, and this one was amazing. You can check out the video up here. And I think all of us were blown away by this amazing solution here of this puzzle. Great design. Today it's time to have a look at the 2016. Again, all of these four locks have been designed by Lewis Coolen from the Netherlands, and if you're interested to get one of these locks, you can check out the video description for some contact. Today it's time for the 2016 puzzle lock, and as you can see here, there's a little bit of nylon powder on my desk already, and this is because I already solved this one. I recorded the video afterwards to provide you some more information, and I can tell you, same as the 2015 lock, this one is amazing. A completely different design, completely different approach and solution, but at the same level, and I was again blown away by the creativity of Lewis. So it's up to you if you just get a copy yourself, or if you watch this video, just enjoy the solving process and be amazed about the solution. Just check out the spoiler break and then we are ready to go. Finally, I can give it a try. So the Trick Lock 2016, let's see. The body is the same size as the other Trick Lock, the 2015 of last episode, but this one is completely closed. The key is also not inside, it's up here, attached up here, and there's only this keyhole, this angled keyhole up front here, which we can do something with. Okay, the shackle is moving the same way as before, and the key I can just take out this time. A little detail here is this little step on the key itself, and it's also angled, same as the one as the keyhole here. I'm doing now what probably everyone will do, as you have seen probably. If I turn this key, the shackle will move down a bit. I'm careful here because it's a very thin piece of plastic, but I cannot twist it in the other direction. It seems it's somehow blocked. I'm really afraid to break this little thing off here. So it was up in here, in this little hole up here, and I just tried to put it in, or check it if I can put it in from both sides. No, still completely blocked. I also noticed something which was hidden before, and this is, there is a little gap here below, inside of the shackle. And I'm pretty much sure this has something to do with the solution. Oh yeah, I think this was step number one. I have no idea what I did, but I did something. So let's see. I can twist the key. You see this? And it seems I'm moving something here inside of the shackle. And you can see, inside of the shackle, there's this little thing, I don't know what it is, never seen something like this before. And this little thing I can move a little bit out of position, where it remains, okay? So I have to take out the key again. It's not only a key, it seems to be a tool that I need to operate here the complete lock. This key is so, the tip of the key really makes me feel... Okay, I got it out again. Let's see what I can do now. Does this move in any kind if I try to twist the key down here? No. I just discovered there's not only one hole over here, but two holes on both sides. So it seems if I move it to one side. Yes! You've seen this? I was able to rotate it from over here all the way to over here. So in the first step I moved the hole over here, and in the second step I took another hole from here and moved it all the way around. It seems there's like a little wheel inside here that I can rotate. I will continue now like this, because there's another little hole here that just appeared. I will continue spinning this one around all the way. Here we go. Yeah, there must be a little wheel inside here with some cutouts, with some small cutouts for this thing here. And I love this idea, having a wheel inside here. It's now well hidden, you can see it. But look at this. Whoa, look at this. Okay, this was what I was talking about. Amazing. And if you align this one properly, in the way I did it before, if you align it like so, you can pull it out. But this is not the last step. The last step is still missing. It cannot be much, to be honest. The locking mechanism up here cannot affect it. So it must be something inside here. Maybe I finally can use now the key here. You see this here? Yeah, it's like a little notch or something in the shackle, which looks very unusual. And I'm pretty much sure this has something to do with the solution or with the locking mechanism in here. But right now I cannot do anything. I'm stuck again. And this is why I love these little things so much, because there's only actually all the time there's only one single step to proceed, but it's very difficult to find. If I pull here right now, it seems to be only locked over here, because this one is basically more or less free, but this one is still locked. So I'm running really out of ideas now, playing with it since a while, but making no progress anymore, just looking the whole time for the detail that makes the difference. Maybe you already discovered it, me didn't. I'm just thinking hard here how to use this key. The locking mechanism is actually out and it locked back in place, so I'm not sure if I did something wrong, but I put it back in the initial condition but without the locking mechanism. How the hell can I get this out? I'm stuck here probably already since 10 minutes or longer without any progress. And I can tell you already, this design is amazing, but I hopefully find also the solution to this amazing design. I cannot really unlock it anymore. It's very confusing because I'm not sure if this is on purpose or not, but depending on how I'm holding this puzzle, it's possible to move this shackle out or not, and this is confusing me a little bit. Oh, I got it! I got it! But how? Okay. Let me just get it together again, because I think this might be kind of confusing here, what I did. Because it took me more than half an hour and I have no idea what I showed you, what details and what not. So I will get it together again and then we solve it one more time, all together, looking at each single step. So let's just check it out again, and now step by step the correct sequence, or what I expect is the correct sequence. The first one is taking out the key, okay? And the key we need for all future operations. The first one is we need to use this little notch down here, or to be exact, the small ring piece that's inside of the notch. And this ring piece has some cutouts, and we can use this key here to get inside of these small cutouts and move the little ring. I think it was two times. We moved it in the correct position. The opening of the little ring is down here, so it's now perfectly aligned that we can get out the latch. And now comes the brilliant move of Lewis, because in this condition it cannot get locked anymore. It can sometimes get slightly locked, but it's easy to unlock it. The brilliant move now that Lewis made was he expected, or I think he expected us to take out this piece. Be curious about it and take it out. And this enables the next mechanism, which is down here, the latch that is floating between left and right, to work at all. If it's in the correct position, it cannot lock itself, because if you remove this one, as I did, and I think Lewis might expect this one, because we are all curious people, of course. And if I do this now and move it, it's gonna get locked again. So not sure if this is on purpose. So I only can unlock it if I hold it in upright condition, bring this little piece back into its centered position, and then I can access the shackle again and move it up and down, okay? So this is a super brilliant move that is just playing with our mind. I really like this one. And the next thing is now to use this key. I was nearly done already. Use this key. We need to put it in here, inside of the keyhole. We pull the shackle out all the way to the top, rotate it until here, and then we need to move this one in again a little bit to be able to move the key a little, turn it a little bit further, and then we can just pull the shackle out. That's it. Yeah, there seems to be some undercut in here, and this little thing, if the key is in between here, it cannot hook to the undercut and it will just come out. So the key just need to be in the correct position. That's it. So overall, this puzzle contains 5 single parts, and I'm amazed by especially the second step, where we, or the third step after we took this one out, that tricks our mind and use our curiosity here to, let's say, make this puzzle even more difficult than it actually should be for us. So same as the 2015, the Trick Lock 2016 is an amazing design. I mean, you saw it, and I can really recommend this one. So if you would like to buy one, of course, link in the video description. If you like this episode, just of course hit the like button, comment below, let me know what you think about this specific puzzle lock, what you think about this series, do you like it, and of course let Lewis know what you think about this amazing design. I mean, there can be only positive feedback, to be honest. And of course, if you would like to learn more about puzzling, just check out my Instagram and Facebook page. So until next time, keep on puzzling!